Hello everyone, today I will discuss a problem related to Newton's law of viscosity. The question is, two large plane surfaces are 2.4 cm apart. The space between the surfaces is filled with glycerin. What force is required to drag a very thin plate of surface area 0.5 m² between the two large plane surfaces at a speed of 0.6 m per second? If, number 1, the thin plate is in the middle of the two plane surfaces, and number 2, the thin plate is at a distance of 0.8 cm from one of the plane surfaces. Take the dynamic viscosity of glycerin as 8.1 into 10 raised to minus 1 Newton second per meter square. Now let us start solving this problem. Before that, let us start writing the given data. Here, two plane surfaces has been given to you, which is 2.4 cm apart. Let us draw two horizontal lines. This is the upper plate and this is the lower plate. The gap between these two plates has been given, which is 2.4 cm. And the space between the surfaces is filled with the glycerin. See, the 2.4 cm of gap, what you can see, has been filled with the glycerin. What force is required to drag a very thin plate of surface area 0.5 cm between the two large plane surfaces at a speed of 0.6 meter per second? Now you have to determine the force which is required to drag the plate of area 0.5 meter square, and the plate is moving with a speed of 0.6 meter per second. And you have to find the force in two cases. One, if the plate is in the middle of the two plane surfaces, and if the plate is at a distance of 0.8 cm from one of the plane surfaces. As I said, these two horizontal lines represent the two plane surfaces. Let us start with the case 1. In the case 1, the thin plate is in the middle of the two plane surfaces. Here, the distance between two plane surfaces is 2.4 cm. Just exactly the middle of this distance, we have to draw a thin plate. And this thin plate is acting at a distance of 1.2 cm on the either side of these two plates. Now, you have to determine the force which is required to drag this thin plate. Let us name F be the force which is required to drag this thin plate. This is the thin plate which is given, and while dragging the plate with F force, the plate is moving with a speed of 0.6 meter per second, and the area of the plate is given as 0.5 meter square. Now let us start writing the data. Let us consider A be the area of the plate, which is 0.5 meter square, and du be the speed of the plate, which is 0.6 meter per second. Whereas dy is the thickness of the glycerin from any one side of the plane surface. See, if you consider the top thickness, then the value is of 1.2 cm, or else you can consider the bottom thickness as 1.2 cm. It is left to you. Any one of the distance you have to consider here. We are finding the force with respect to any one plane surfaces. Either you consider the top plane surface or bottom plane surface. So that's why we are taking the value of dy here as 1.2 cm. As the area and velocity is in terms of meter, we need to convert this centimeter in terms of meter, for which you have to divide this value with 100. On dividing this value with 100, you will be getting 0.012 meter. And here the dynamic viscosity of the glycerin is also given. Let us consider mu be the dynamic viscosity, and the value is 8.1 into 10 raised to minus 1 Newton second per meter square. Now let us start applying the Newton's law of viscosity here. The Newton's law says that shear stress is directly proportional to its shear strain of the fluid. That is, tau is equal to mu into du by dy. This is the formula to find the shear stress. To find force, we first have to find the shear stress of the fluid. So now, in this formula, tau is unknown. You need to find the value of du here, because the values of mu and dy are given in the question itself. I am naming this as tau 1 and this as dy 1 just because here there are two cases which is given in the question. So for that reason, I am just naming this as this shear stress as tau 1, that is for case 1, and dy 1 represent the thickness of the glycerin for the case 1. Now let us start finding the value of du. Here du is also given. The du represents the change in the velocity. See, the change in the velocity is given by final velocity minus initial velocity. Here the final velocity is the velocity of the plate at which it is moving. In the question, the velocity of the plate is given as 0.6 minus initial velocity. Initial velocity will be always considered as the velocity at which the plate is at rest. If the plate is at rest, then the velocity will be zero. So on solving this, you will be getting the value of du as 0.6. That's why I had taken du directly equal to the velocity of the plate. Here we are considering V as the velocity of the plate. Hence, the value of du I have directly written as V, which is equal to 0.6 meter per second. Now let us substitute the value of mu, du and dy1 in this equation. Mu is 8.1 into 10 raised to minus 1 into du is 0.6 divided by dy1 is 0.012. Simplify this. On simplifying, you will be getting the value of tau 1 as 40.5 Newton per meter square. This value gives you the value of the shear stress of the plate with respect to the top of the plane surface. Similarly, you have to find the shear force of this thin plate with respect to the bottom plane surface. See, to find the shear force for the bottom plane surface, I am taking this as tau 2 and dy as dy 2. Now, once again, you write the formula for Newton's shear stress, that is tau 2 is equal to mu into du by dy 2. In this formula, you substitute the values of mu, du and dy 2. See, the value of dy 2 is 1.2 centimeter. You again have to convert it in terms of meter. On converting it, you will be getting a value 0.012. Whereas du and mu remain same. You substitute the value of mu, du, dy 2 in this formula. Simplify it. You will be getting the value of tau 2 as 40.5 Newton per meter square, as same as the value of tau 1. Because for both the cases, the values of mu, du and dy are same. Now, let us start finding the force. See, in the question, it is being asked you to find the force which is required to drag the plate. Here, let us consider F1 be the force which is required to drag the plate with respect to the upper plate. Similarly, F2 be the force which is required to drag the thin plate with respect to the lower plane surface. Now, we know that the general formula to find the stress is force by area. In this formula, I want to write the formula for force, for which I need to cross multiply this equation. On cross multiplying, I will be getting a formula for force as shear stress into area. This is stress, or we can consider this as shear stress. Now by considering this formula, our formula to find F1 is written as tau 1 into A1, which is nothing but shear stress into area of the thin plate. Similarly, The second formula to find F2 is 2 into A2. Here A1 is equal to A2 because both the areas represents the area of the thin plate which remains constant, that is 0.5 meter square. I can write this as is equal to A1 is equal to A2. Now we got the values of toe 1, toe 2. We know the value of A1, A2. You substitute these two values in these two equations. Simplify it. You will be getting the value 20.25 Newton for both forces. Once you get these two values, you have to find the total force which is required to drag the plate. Let us consider F be the total force which is required to drag the plate, and this is given by the formula F1 plus F2. You know the value of F1, F2, that is 20.25. Substitute it, simplify it. You will be getting a value as 40.5 Newton. This 40.5 Newton is the force which is required to drag this thin plate for the first case, if the plate is in the middle of the two plane surfaces. Now this completes the case 1.